Hello, I'm Christy, and welcome to my reading journal. Today we're going to wrap up the last books that I read during September that I haven't already reviewed in previous videos. So the last time I had talked about Pink Lemonade Cake Murder. So over here, A Werewolf's Guide to Seducing a Vampire by Sarah Hawley, which is book three in the Glimmer Falls series. I did it for a sidekick for Slayer Fest. 13 hours, 448 pages, August 2024 is when it was published. And I chose Howling for You by the Black Keys for the song. If you don't want any spoilers, don't read what I write. So this time we're following Ben, who is he's a store owner of this local nursery, and he's also a werewolf. And after going to Mariel's and Oz's wedding, those are the couples from the first book, he ends up getting drunk and ordering like a dollar plastic thing that's supposed to be like, not a seductress, a succubus, in a little plastic thing, and he wakes up to find out, yeah, it was real. It's really a vampire succubus that had been trapped in there. And so it just goes from there. But I do like how we got to know more about Ben, more about this succubus vampire. I really like the quirkiness of the relationship, and I thought this was fun, and I gave it 4 stars. From the library, I had checked out This Wretched Valley by Jennifer Kiefer. Sorry, I'm filming this outside, so you might hear cars going by. I did the physical and the audiobook. 8 hours, 304 pages, January 2024 was when it was published. I gave it 3.5 stars. I chose A Forest by The Cure. And for Slayer Fest, prompt 9, a beautiful cover or a cover by, plus at least three POVs. And there were 4 main POVs plus several others as on top of that. So this is a debut novel by Jennifer Kiefer, who co-owns a horror themed bookstore with her mother in Kentucky, and she is also a rock climber. So she combined all of that. So this is a rock climber and 3 other people. One person is her boyfriend, who holds like the belaying, like the ropes and stuff for her. And one person is like a scout for places to climb, and another person is their person who's documenting everything. And they're in the Kentucky wilderness in uncharted territory for rock climbers, but it's a haunted forest, and there's time loss here and spooky stuff happening. It just missed the mark on being creepy for me and being gross, because there was this gore factor in it. It just slightly missed the mark, but if this is her debut novel, I can see how they're just going to get better as she grows as an author. Wow, there are a lot of cars that are passing by over here, and it's a dead-end street. So that's really weird. Anyway, we get some background on some of the previous things that have happened in this forest as well. It looks like I forgot to write the number over there of the book. I sure did. Okay, and then I had pre-ordered Somewhere Beyond the Sea by TJ Klune, which is the second book in the Cerulean Sea series, and I gave it 4.5 stars. For Slayer Fest, it was for prompt 10, your newest acquisition. I had gotten the ebook, so I had started reading the ebook when finally the audiobook was available. I didn't think I'd actually be able to get the audiobook at all this month. 16 hours, 416 pages, and published September 2024. The audiobook is great. I mean, all the different voices and everything, I do recommend that. I chose Beyond the Sea by Bobby Darin. Surprise, surprise. But I also put together a whole playlist on Spotify for the book, for all the songs that are mentioned in the book. And I thought this was super cute. We start off with Arthur and Linus going to this hearing by Dichotomy, or the higher people of it, to state Arthur's background and, you know, his case for why things should be changing and all that. But we find out that one of the people is trying to do covert manipulative stuff, and she comes off like, Umbridge from Harry Potter, Professor Umbridge. So she gives off those kind of vibes. And while they're there, they pick up David is a Yeti whose parents were killed by hunters, and take him back to the island with them. And then a secret agent of Dichotomy, but also an investigator, comes and tries to weed out any kind of misdoings, but I don't want to get too far into it. But there's high stakes involved over whether or not they get to keep the kids, what lengths Arthur will do to keep the kids. You see a lot of growth in the kids. There's a lot of laugh out loud moments in this, which is great. David is an excellent additional character to the book. It all gets wrapped up nicely. You do get hit over the head with the mallet with the moral of the story. But that being said, that didn't actually take away from the story itself. I recommend it. Yeah. Over here, you'll see a blank spot here. I forgot to print out a sticker for the playlist that I made for this. I wanted to have the whole playlist like put there. Not the whole playlist, but a picture of it. So Year Zero by Rob Reed, I had found at Goodwill. And that was part of my hardest reading challenge you'll ever do, is to find books at thrift stores or Goodwill or free library or garage sales or whatever to read. Three of them. So this is my first book going there. I gave it 3 stars. I read the physical and listened to the audio. 10 hours, 364 pages, published July of 2012. And I chose Money by Pink Floyd. And like I said, I did put together a whole playlist for this, but it is based on, not based, it is all the playlists combined that are in the back of the book, minus 5 songs that I couldn't find. And for Slayer Fest, for the Big Bag Bingo, I chose Sweet Read a Book Featuring Music in Some Way, and this whole thing is about music. So basically, October 13th, 1977, Welcome Back Carter's theme song reached the outskirts of the universe, and all these aliens completely fell in love with Earth's music and started listening to it and obsessing over it, so much so that that date became, they reset their clocks, so that became Year Zero. And they even renamed a whole bunch of stuff, like the metal-based aliens are named after heavy metal bands and members and stuff. So we meet Ozzy, who is made out of Metallicam, after Metallica. There's also Van Helium and Def Leppamite, which is used for prosthetic limbs because, well, Def Leppard's drummer only has one arm. So there's a lot of puns that revolve around music, which was funny. It was trying to go for a Hitchhiker's Guide Douglas Adams kind of feel, kind of fell short because there's a lot of legal stuff going on here, because they like to obey laws and they owe us a lot of money in copyright violations. But some of them want to destroy our planet just to get out of debt, or because we ruin their careers by having better music. But then some of them are trying to help us work around. So it's up to Nick Carter, no, not that Nick Carter, a copyright lawyer, to help them figure out how to not destroy Earth, but also not to have this overwhelming debt to Earth for the copyright violations. Silly. It was great in the beginning, and then it just, it's a solid 3-star. And then I needed to read a nonfiction book. So I saw Brat and 80 Stories by Andrew McCarthy at the library. So I found the audiobook. It's actually read by Andrew McCarthy. It's 5 hours long, 223 pages, and published May of 2021. I used the song from Mannequin, which he starred in. Nothing's gonna stop us. Nothing's gonna stop us now. If I can talk right, by Starship. And for Slayerfest, for the Big Bad Bingo, Vampire Read, read a short, quick read. Okay, so basically, this is not a full memoir about Andrew McCarthy. This is about a little bit of his childhood, how he fell in love with acting, and how he, where he went to school, and how he got started in his whole acting career, and then moving on into like how he got roles for movies, and his drug and alcohol addiction, some of his relationships with people, other actors, and just other actors who he met along the way. If you're looking for juice or dirt, there's none in there, except I didn't know he was an alcoholic. And his struggle with that. There's a few interesting stories. I mean, I enjoyed his narration of it a lot. It was 3.5 stars for me. And that wraps up the last of what I read this month. I'm gonna be also posting a video where I just quickly go through what books I read for the entire month. But thank you so much for joining me. Bye.